Did you know that during the American Revolution, over 5,000 African Americans fought for the ideals of freedom and democracy? At the time, slavery was common in every U.S. state. And while some Americans believed it had no place in a country striving for independence and equality, others strongly disagreed. But what about the people in charge? What did the Founding Fathers think? Like many, Patriot General George Washington's personal views on slavery changed as the war progressed. He witnessed black soldiers fighting bravely alongside white soldiers and listened to his junior officers claim that slavery was wrong. But Washington never took a public stance against slavery, though he was the only founding father to free his slaves in his will. The principles of the American Revolution and the opening words of the Declaration of Independence inspired some slave owners to free enslaved people during the 1780s. And in 1787, New York's Governor Morris gave an impassioned speech to the Constitutional Convention denouncing slavery. But many Southern delegates, made rich from slavery, did not want to debate the matter at all. And as the difference between the North and South's economic reliance on slavery intensified, the debate over the issue of slavery did too. The Constitution was a compromise to preserve the union of the states over finding a solution. So why does it matter? When we explore the tensions and divisions that existed in America over the issue of slavery, both during and after the American Revolution, we can begin to understand why the country descended into civil war the following century. Some historians have claimed the Civil War was inevitable. What do you think?